r/askreddit. When did you realize that you didn't have a normal family? My parents hosted Christmas one year when I was a teen. A bunch of our family came over and got super drunk. Our Jewish neighbor called and said we should all stop by and say hi at their Hanukkah party. 10 to 15 drunk people walked down the street barefoot and with pitchers of mixed drinks in our hands. We entered their house and they were having a very quiet Hanukkah with 10 very sober seeming people eating and talking here and there. That quickly changed to 20 to 25 super loud drunk people having fun, and at one point having a southern rap battle where everyone contributed to the song with their best southern accent and southern verses. The next day our neighbor thanked us so much for coming. He said everyone, including the old Jewish ladies, had a blast. When I was 8 and found my parents, empty methadone bottles in a bag, to go back to the methadone clinic. The next time I was at the library, I embarked on an hour of research using the Encyclopedia Britannica and various medical books and magazines. This was back in the 80s. I eventually figured out that methadone was for drug addicts to stop doing drugs. I read about heroin and how bad it was. I read about what methadone clinic were and how people didn't like junkies. And then it slowly dawned on my why every day after kindergarten my dad used to take me into the nearest city to hang out at in the kids play area of this weird clinic. The people there were always nice, but I never knew why we were there. I realized then that even though I didn't totally understand it, my parents had struggles that were much different than those of most parents. I think my parents knew I had figured it out. A few months later they explained everything to me. They had both been heroin addicts before my birth, but had gotten clean. They both stayed clean the rest of their lives, both too short, sadly. My dad stayed on methadone till the day he died decades later. They were awesome, amazing parents. But the methadone is, as they say, liquid handcuffs. We could never really go on family trips, because he had to be at the clinic to pick up his dose. And money was sometimes tight, because methadone is expensive. And the most weird thing that made us not like other families was always having this secret. No matter how normal they seemed, or how successful their lives were, the past addiction always loomed just overhead. I'll share some of the less extreme ones. Keep in mind that my parents are actually quite nice and loving. Too much so, actually. But that's a whole nother story. Here's some weird shit they did. Also, they are immigrants. 1. My dad would wash his ass in the bathroom sink after he pooped. Like, he would fill the sink halfway, hop up with his legs dangling off the counter, and would just sit there reading the newspaper for like 10 minutes. Then he'd hop off, drain the sink, and dry off with the hand towel. I was taught to do it too as a kid, and thought nothing of it. I realized one day how fucking weird that was during an epiphany. 2. My mom would start ripping into me at random. Like, she would start yelling at me to do homework. If I was caught up for the day, she would start bringing up other shit that happened months or years ago, until she found something I couldn't defend. These sessions would go on for hours, and any attempts to stop them would lead to more aggressive yelling or some violence. I'd just be sitting there watching TV and suddenly I'm getting reamed for some sweater I lost years ago. Then shit would transition to how I'll never live up to my brother's success, yada yada. 3. My parents believed that making a child eat more would make them taller. So they would make me eat a lot. I would eat until I was in pain and begging them to stop. Then they would make me eat more. Sometimes I'd be crying in pain, but fuck it. Here's some more fucking rice, bitch. There were a few times where my stomach just couldn't handle it and I'd throw up and they would set my mom off. She'd start hitting me and yelling about wasting food. Then she'd made start eating all over again. 4. Looking back, my parents didn't seem to give a shit about wearing seatbelts. When I was very young, I was sleeping in the back seat of my mom's minivan when she crashed straight into a tree. I wasn't wearing a seatbelt, so I flew forward and ricocheted off the seat in front of me. Apparently, I bounced back and went headfirst through the rear windshield. I just remember waking up in a muddy ditch. I was told my mom popped the airbag with her face. I was with my mom when she crashed 2 more cars and I don't think I was wearing a seatbelt any of those times. I remember once somersaulting from the 3rd row into the back of the driver's seat during the time she crashed in the city. None of us ever really learned from these events and I would often ride in the minivan. by folding down one of the second row seats and riding on top of it as if it were a horse. No seat belts, of course. We went on fucking road trips like this. 5. None of the doors in the house were allowed to be closed at all. So we would shit with the doors open, sleep with the doors open, shower with the doors open, etc. The entire fucking house had a mandatory open door policy, so there was never any knocking or warning. If a door was closed, my mom would violently open it and start interrogating me on why it was closed. My mom said the doors needed to be open so that we didn't suffocate to death if we fell asleep in one of the rooms, but I'm still not convinced that it wasn't at least partially for surveillance purposes. Anyways, since we only lived in small houses and small apartments, you could hear everything, everywhere, at all times. I got pretty good at stealth masturbating as a teenager, but my parents had to have known. Bonus, one time I couldn't find my English homework in my backpack at the beginning of class. My teacher was furious and made me call my mom. Mom vows to punish me. English teacher gives me extra homework for that night, and my grade takes a hit. So I got home later and asked my mom if she had seen my English homework. She pulls out a handful of papers and gives them to me. Lo and behold, it was my essay. I asked my mom why she had snuck into backpack and removed my assignment, and she told me that it was my fault for having a messy backpack. So I still got fucking punished. I still had to the fucking extra homework, and I took a full letter grade penalty on the fucking essay because I couldn't come up with a way to reasonably explain why my mom looted my backpack and only took out my homework. Plus, I was weirded out by the privacy invasion. It took me an embarrassingly long time to realize that not everyone's mom will come up with a song for the pets. My mom sings about our dogs wearing pajamas in the car. When the dogs get excited and start running around, she will sing them a song. She has made a song for each of our pets. They all have their own personal lyrics and tune. Some of us have started singing the songs when we see that specific pet, and some of the pets now respond. My tortoise Ishul will bound up and meow at you if you sing her song. When I always had people saying that it's so cool how much we do together. Not to brag at all, that isn't what I'm getting at. My family does everything together, and not because it's forced, but because we want to. We play video games together all the time, and I'm not talking about the typical "oh, we play video games together" stuff, where they play the Monopoly Fun Pack, or whatever. We play EverQuest 2, EverQuest, World of Warcraft, Warcraft 3, Age of Wonders 2 and 3, Mass Effect 3, Smash Brothers, Diablo III, Diablo, Sword Coast Legends, Quake, etc. We are super excited about Cyberpunk 2077, and can't wait for that. Our idea of a typical family night was either that, or instead of just watching a movie, we would watch our dad play through whatever he latest RPG. It was a ton of fun all sitting down together on the couch to watch him play through the Mass Effect trilogy. It was like an interactive movie for us. Right now it is Final Fantasy 15. We have 3 PS4s, 2 PS3s, 4 computers, tons of old game systems, SNES, Northeasts, GameCube, PlayStation, PlayStation 2, etc. Tons of board games like Twilight Imperium or Axis and Allies. Me and my mother both have a thirds, and we are always playing Fire Emblem or Pokemon, visiting each other's My Castle, or trading Pokemon, and helping each other out. We even play D&D 3.5 together, along with Cyberpunk and Heroes System. It's all in my dad's own created version of like an alternate Earth. They all tie in together too, like one big MCU. D&D is the past before a big cataclysm. Cyberpunk and Heroes are simultaneous. Some D&D characters have made it to the future, whether through time travel, or for example, my latest character got turned into a weird vampire-like being and is still alive in the future. Close bracket. My dad is a huge comic book fan. He has 2 large plastic tubs full of X-Men comics from the 80s and 90s. We all go to the day of a release of a Marvel movie, or really any movie we are interested in. That and anime. My mom was actually the one to get me into that. We got our dad watching Raw by now too, so we binge watched that a week or so ago. Football is also a big deal in my house. My whole family is a huge Patriots fan. My dad also played football in high school, and so does my brother. My dad jokes around about being the jock turned geek when he was in school. And it's not like we aren't social either. My mom runs organizing the overheads and various teams for our church. My brother is one of the middle school youth leaders. I help with the overheads for church itself. The slides and the computers that have everything on it for the service, like videos. We hold neighborhood cookouts for holidays like Halloween. I'm part of a club at the college, etc. There is a lot more we do together too. And like I said, it's all willingly. At this point I'm in college, and I'm close to my 20th birthday, and I still love hanging out with my mom, dad, and younger brother for an evening. Our dream idea is that we all live nearby each other, so that when me and my brother inevitably move out and get our own lives, we still live close enough by that we can still do things together. This was all normal to me though, because I grew up with it. At the same time, we are this way because we have gone through some really rough times where all we had were each other. My mom had cancer, which left her with a really weak immune system, and diabetes, sickness, rough spots financially, while my dad went through college, moving all the time, etc. The more and more I talk to people about it though, the more I realized that the experiences I have had with my family aren't the normal thing, which makes me appreciate what I have even more. Every year for Easter, my parents would set up a video camera in the living room overnight so that we can catch the Easter bunny in the act while he hid our baskets and colored eggs around the house. We would go to bed right after we set it up and started recording. After about 20 minutes of recording, a stuffed animal bunny would be hopping around the living room using a stop motion technique that my parents used, hopping around hiding our eggs and baskets. As kids, we thought it was absolutely amazing that we caught the real Easter bunny in the act. When we would have family over for Easter dinner, we would show everyone how sneaky and clever we were that we got it on camera. Kinda weird, but I cannot wait to do this to my kids one day. When my dad had to go to a rehabilitation center for suicidal tendencies, he had mapped out my mom's finances for the next 5 years based off of her salary and his life insurance, and had planned to hang himself. When he presented his plan to my mother, she said he'd read it to her as plainly as if he was reading off a grocery list for her approval. He seriously thought it was a good idea, because in his mind, his depression caused him to be a drain on her. That or by the third time we were rushing out to my half-sister's college town for another suicide attempt, only to again find her happy to see us, and happy for the extra attention. She has borderline personality disorder. We don't speak. I was in my first therapy session. I explained to the therapist that I had just gone crazy 10 years ago for no reason, and I felt really bad about imposing my crazy on my family. But she pointed out I had also told her my sister was on the autism spectrum and tried to murder me several times. I don't want to insinuate that one led to the other, but both were difficult for me for different reasons. My dad literally wouldn't come home from work sometimes, and my mom spent at least half the month in bed with migraines for most of my childhood, before going temporarily crazy due to hyperthyroidism. Later I'd come to realize dad is also an alcoholic pothead, and we're one of the sanest branches of my family, so. Thanks for watching UpGoatReddit. Try like and subscribe button, if it still works.